Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, I ran into a scenario where I think we need a surrogate key in order to actually make this model work. We've got a list of like a parent and child, and the child keeps resetting. Enough of all this talking. You know we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, here's the scenario. If we go over to our model view, we can look. We've got, you know, sales territory. We got calendar table. That's great. And then we've got the sales table with this child ID and entity ID. And so we need to go pull in the data that corresponds to this from a dimension perspective. So let me just go ahead and get the Excel workbook where the data is, and we'll go and pull that in. And this is a great example of why you should not hit the load button, but instead transform data. I know that load button is inviting. It wants you to click it, but don't do it because we got to change things up here. We're not done. So let's hit transform data. First off, look at this data. So we got entity ID, child ID. We got a name, we got a color, we got a price. It's a product table, right? So child ID is the product key, and then entity ID is the category key. So let's go ahead and rename this and we'll just call it products. The challenge we have here is you'll see here that for category one, we have product key of 1 through 10. And then for category two, we've got 1 through 10. And then category three, we have 1 through 10. That ain't gonna work. I can't do a relationship against that because the ID is not unique. Let's try it. So if we go to our sales table, we'll see here also that we've got our child ID, we've got our entity ID. So what I wanna do is join on this child ID. So let's just go ahead and load it in. Let's see what happens. All right, so now if I try and do child ID to child ID, it's gonna suggest a many to many. And that's not gonna work because the many to many, it's not unique on either side. So it's not gonna give us the relationship that we're looking for. And so we gotta do something with this data. So let's cancel that. We'll go back into transform data. And that would have happened if you hit the load button, right? So the first thing I need to do is I need to get a unique value for the child ID column. So we'll go to add column. We'll use index, right? So this will give it to us. We'll do from one. And now we've got a continuous number from 1 through 30 for the different rows that we have, which is great. So let's rename that product ID. And then at this point, you may think, let's get rid of the child ID, but don't do that yet. We've got something else we've got to do here. The product ID here is effectively our surrogate key, right? So we're creating an ID that represents the uniqueness of the dimension, but that ID doesn't really exist anywhere else, right? So we've generated that on our end as part of a modeling perspective. And so now what I need to do is go back to that sales table and make sure that surrogate key is represented there so that I can do the join. The other thing I will say here, please follow Matthew Roach's maxim of data transformation. Transformation should be performed as far upstream as possible and as far downstream as necessary. Ideally here, if you're working with a source, do this as part of your data warehouse load. In this case, I've got an Excel file. If you're working with small data, it's probably fine. But just know that the larger the data here is, you're putting this pressure on Power Query itself or on the Power BI side, right? And that's more expensive. And so you need to be careful because you're probably going to break the fold. And we don't want to break the fold. But in this case, we're probably going to break the fold. And be aware that this is going to potentially impact performance from a refresh or processing perspective. So we need to get this back into the sales table. So what do I do? Well, in this case, we're probably just going to do a merge query here. You may be thinking like, oh, well, Power BI only supports relationships against one column. I can't do a compound key. That is true from a Power BI perspective, but from a Power Query merge perspective, I can do a compound key. So let's do entity ID and child ID on the sales table. We'll pick our products table. And this is why I didn't delete the child ID yet. Cool. Our numbers match. Let's hit OK. Bam. Now we've got our items here. So let's go ahead and I will uncheck this. I only want to bring in the product ID for that match. We'll hit get rid of the prefix. And now we've got our product ID, which is great. This looks amazing. And if we go back now, technically I can get rid of both of these, but I may want the category ID. So at this point, let's just go ahead and get rid of child ID here and we should be okay. The child ID on the product side, if we get rid of this here, it's going to break the merge. So let's try that. Let's see what happens here. Yeah. See, we broke the merge at that point because it doesn't know what it is. So you can't get rid of it on the products table. That's okay. We can get rid of it on the sales table because it's after the point of the merge. All of our items are good. If we go back to products, everything there looks good. Let's go ahead and close and apply. And now what we can see is this relationship was created, product ID to product ID. And now what you can do here is we could just hide that child ID column. And so from a report perspective, you're not going to see it. Right? It's not going to be there at all. You'll just see this entity ID and then you'll see product ID. Honestly, we don't even need product ID as well. So we can go back and hide those. And then if we go back in, we just have our name, right? So if we come into name, we can do a bar chart. There's going to be a lot of stuff here. And then we can bring in our total sales amount and life should be good. There we go. And we could even do a hierarchy. Ideally, you'd have a category name of some kind. So if we brought that in, we'd see that category 2's got pretty much nothing, 3's got stuff, and then 1's got a lot of stuff. And then we can drill down into the actual items themselves. So from a Power Query perspective, you can create that surrogate key if you need to, and then bring it back into the main table so that you can actually leverage it and create that join. And now we've got a holistic item, because on the Power BI side, that join on child ID wouldn't have worked. And I can't do a compound join on multiple keys. All right. Let me know in the comments what you think. Is there another way that you go about this? Obviously, do it further upstream, right? Do it in your database. That's the best way to do it. And then we can just pull in the clean data from a Power BI perspective. Life is good. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.